Hi, my name is Dave Andrews. Today I'm going to show you how to create a for next loop in Excel VBA. Let's begin by opening up Excel. I'm going to click on my start button. I'm just going to launch Excel. Now, once you have Excel open, let's open up the Excel VBA by holding down the Alt key on the keyboard, pressing F11. This opens up your Visual Basic Editor for Excel. I'm going to make it to where I can see a little better. And we're going to double click on Sheet 1. What we're going to do is we're going to put some code in here that runs when Sheet 1 is activated. So next to General, click the little drop down and select Worksheet. And let's say Activate. We're going to type some code into here. Here's our finished code. As you can see, the very first thing that I did is create two variables, row as an integer, and call we actually didn't use, so I can delete that. Only one variable, row. The next variable I created was WS, and that's going to be of an object of type worksheet. Now what I did was I set the WS value equal to the active workbook, which is the current workbook you're working in, and I pulled in sheet 1 out of the sheets array for that workbook. Now we did our for next loop right here. The way you do it is you say for row, which is an integer, equals 1 to 5. Basically what that's going to do is count from 1 to 5 and assign those values to your row variable as it goes along. So the first time row will be 1, the next time row will be 2, then row will be 3, 4, and 5, and on. Now, inside of this loop, we say set the worksheets cell row equal to the current row that it's looping through, column 1. So that means in the first column, rows 1 to 5, we're going to set their values to be hello. This next row ends the for next loop and tells it to loop back to the beginning. So, if we will minimize our VBA, and then click on Sheet 2, and then click on Sheet 1 to activate it, which remember that's where the function we put our code into was. You can see that in the first column, numbers 1 through 5 are filled in with our text, hello. That's how you create a for next loop in Excel. My name is Dave Andrews, and I've just showed you how to create a for next loop using Excel VBA.